Hey everybody, welcome back. It is now morning day 52, and I've been working away down in the basement, and I carved out a bunch more stone just kind of randomly across the street over in that little area that I don't care about. And all the forges downstairs are pumping out brick paver, including these now. I'm actually going to start pumping out. So all these forges downstairs and these two forges are going to be helping me with brick paver. This one here, I'm undecided. I think I'm just going to leave this one to keep active towards steel. I did find some resources down below, so what we'll do is we'll keep this one just sucking up iron and clay. We don't actually need to craft anything. What I want to do first thing this morning is go and fill up our water bottles. Now there's screamers coming in. There was a huge horde that came in. Oh, and look over there. I see something over there. Let's go check this out real quick. I want to see what's going on. With this block sitting on top of my thing here. This might have been from the house falling. This might have been a gore block. Okay, so that was from the house falling, probably. So yeah, there's the... We have to check this wall out, because there was a whole crap load of zombies, a wandering horde. Huge one that came in. And I didn't deal with them, I was just busy downstairs, so I figured I'd stay busy. Looks like there was dogs. Looks to me like... Well, it's hard to say, I need to have my repair tool on me to check the damages, but... Everything seems to be okay. Usually you can tell when they're cracked real bad. Say there's a little bit of damage on these ones, but nothing serious. So we don't really need to worry about repairing right now. So let's go fill up our water bottles, our jars. Because that's basically what I want to do right now. And I do have a bunch of brick paver that we can start placing down to help zombie-proof the base a little bit. So we'll do that after. Our wellness is up to 120, so that's really good. And now aside from placing down the brick paver and stuff like that, I'm not too sure what we want to do here. We could continue to try to decorate the base, maybe get some furniture in. Stuff like that. Remember to be careful by our spikes, because they will give you a bleed buff. May as well take out these stragglers. I don't know how he hit me. Quite frankly, I do not like it. Excuse me. Just gotta stay further back so we don't get hit. Excellent. Oops. think what I'll do is I'll take this over the feather. Oops. There. Holy crap, they just come in from everywhere. It never ends. Holy Christ. I could fight these guys all day, literally. Let's not worry about it right now. Is that a deer? Oh my god, now there's a deer. What can we get rid of? Where did that deer go? There he is. Oh my god, he saw me. Damn it. I suck at aiming. Now, we don't absolutely need this deer, but it would be nice. Holy Christ. Stop moving around. Oh my god. Please stop moving. What the hell? That was right on him. Oh my god. Thank you. Jesus. Grab that grass. Whoa. I don't think so. Come here. Get over here. Crunch. Holy crap, he took a beating. He's stuck in the wall. Okay, I'm trying to break the thing. Hit the, oh my god, hit the zombie. Jesus. Hit the dirt for no reason. Holy crap. Does it again. Twice he hit me there for he should not have been able to. I didn't even know she was there. Christ, there's so many of them. This isn't even a wandering horde. I think he's dead. Jesus. Come on, I just want to collect some frickin' water here, guys. These guys I don't like. They can hit me more frequently than the other ones. Holy crap. This never ends. Holy crap. I just want to deal with these guys so that they're done out of this area for a while. Oh my god. Okay, time to heal up. Come on, zombies. I don't think I'm gonna use guns. At least not unless I'm on against ferals and cops and stuff like that. Excellent. Deals with those assholes. Okay. Now, we can actually get our frickin' water. Now this has happened before, and then it like fixed itself, or something, like water came back, because it was over here happening. And then a few days later I came back and it wasn't happening anymore. So I don't know if that's gonna fix itself or what, but hopefully it does. Now, as much as I'd like to collect all this stuff, I'm just gonna get rid of the stuff so that it's not a mess everywhere. That way it doesn't call in any screamers either. There. And this area is cleared out now, so we don't have to worry about zombies for a few days anyway. we don't need feathers and stuff like that. We got lots at home, and we got chicken coops that are constantly giving us feathers every 6 days, I believe it is. And we hardly use the arrows, which I do actually want to get my archery skill up. Would be really nice. Get the perk for that, get the Legolas perk, and start decapitating zombies a lot easier with bow and arrow. Would be kind of fun. Okay, so what do we got to drop off here? We gotta drop some shit off real quick, like. Now the main reason I need that water is for coffee, goldenrod. Six minutes. Been there for seven. That should be more than good enough. Lots of schematic pages I'd like to be able to... We don't have any blueberries, I don't think. Oh yeah, we do. So we can start making some ink. Oops. Put that one in there. Oh, I should have grabbed those jars too. Oh well, no big deal. Okay, so what do we need for our ink? That's what I need to check here. I can't remember. So it is bottled water, animal fat, and blueberries. So we'll make a bit of ink. That's 6 minutes. Just for 13 ink. But I mean, that's gotta be... It's gotta take a while for ink, because... To tell you the truth, it can be pretty overpowered if when you got like a whole crap load of schematic pages like I do. I don't know which skill we're gonna focus on, but... We will focus on something. Actually, I think weaponsmithing, because I want to get my freaking weaponsmithing skill up, and I don't want to have to grind. Even though I could probably focus on much better skills than weaponsmithing, something that I can't actually grind so easily, but meh, I don't care. Let's place down these blocks and get as many of these placed down as we can. The sooner we get this area zombie-proof, the better. I'll be real happy. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. I really like the look of that brick paver. And we'll head downstairs and we'll start crafting some more, because I think that our furnaces will be ready. And with all of them sucking stuff up, even if there's only like 20 per forge, that's, you know, that's times how many do we have downstairs? I can't remember. 6 plus another 2 upstairs, so that's 8. So yeah, that's pretty good. We'll be able to do this fairly quickly, I think. And our entrance, we still have to worry about that. Oh man, I don't know exactly where our entrance is gonna go. I have to figure that out from down below. Holy crap, this is actually going quite a ways. So that's really good. Okay, so let's go grind. Let's go get some more, because that's starting to look really good. And then this area will be zombie-proof. I'm just going to cover up my area for the entrance, and we'll worry about that after. We might do that next episode, I'm not too sure. I kind of want to decorate downstairs too, but I'm not entirely sure what I want to do for decorating down there. Actually, let's just check really quick here. And let's look at the sofa. I do want to make the sofa, I think. So, I mean, that's going to take cloth, cotton. That's basically why I stopped, because of the cloth and the cotton. Because we do have the springs and the pipes. See, we got the springs, we got the pipes. It's just the cloth and the cotton, so we might have to go for a little cotton run. Let's go pick up as much of this paver as we can. I've already got a bunch crafting, so I can't remember how much though. But there's a bunch. There's the kitchen sort of. It's not done yet. Holy crap, 106 just from that one? Yeah, we'll be moving along pretty quickly, I think. I want to make sure I actually did click on paver. Yeah, I did, okay. Oh, these ones are missing clay, eh? Okay. Okay, so I gotta go upstairs and I gotta grab clay. Okay, so we gotta go grab some clay. We gotta keep these forges going. We got another 207 just from that though, and I mean, I just started those in the morning, so. So yeah, we're gonna come along real fast. Base will be zombie-proof before you know it. The real bitch is gonna be taking down that bookstore. Yeah, give me all the clay. Well, maybe not all of it, but a lot of it. Give me all that, too. Is there any stone as well? No, the stone is used that bookcase. Let's go down there real quick. We'll get those forges fired back up. That won't take long here. And then maybe we'll get our sofa started. That would be alright, maybe. So we got lots of wood in there for now. Wood seems to be alright, they're burning for a while, so that's good. We do have stone down here as well, so that's really good. Okay, so let's go place these blocks down. Actually, let's grab what's already been crafted here, we might as well. Since they're done already. For the most part, anyway. not going to worry about those few small ones that are a few seconds ready, but we got 314, which is more than what we had this morning already, so that's awesome. I wasn't expecting to get the whole thing done today, but, well, at least the area that I dug out so far. But it looks like it's becoming more and more possible here. Just want to check up here real quick. Yeah, that's ready. See, that's why I want lots of these, so I don't really need to, like, refill my jars. Like deplete the water sources and stuff like that. Okay, so we have ink. Let's get crafting. Oops, wrong one. Our weaponsmithing, right? Yeah, I think so. Weaponsmithing. What are we missing? Ink, feathers. Oh, it takes. We're gonna need more paper. But still, that's pretty good. And like, well, I'll wait till I have two of them. There we go. To be sure, because two of these will level my skill up all the way. Like one level. At least it should. It's supposed to. Weaponsmithing, level 70. This is weaponsmithing, yes it is. So I'm gonna have to look into that. It's supposed to. Two books are supposed to level it up. So I might have to increase that. No big deal though. Not a big deal, that's easy to fix. Just pisses me off because I thought I had fixed it. Excuse me? What the hell? Get rid of all this grass. Oops. It's the only thing I don't like is that it damages the floor. That's gonna bother me. Even though they're underneath the, like, bricks, it's gonna bother me that there's some damage blocks there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna repair them. Just because I want to. And if this guy would stop whining about being thirsty and hungry ever. Excellent. Okay, because we do need our repair gun at some point. I know I hit more dirt than that. Whatever. Good enough. As long as I think that it's all frickin' repaired, then I'm happy. What I don't know won't hurt me. Okay, so got another 230, so this should actually do a hefty chunk of this. What I'm thinking. Now we do want a tree farm and a grass farm as well, so I'm thinking the tree farm, like when this building comes down, we'll have this whole area. Like this is going to be farms from here over, regular farm. And then we have that corner section, and we kind of have this area here to think about as well, what we can do with it. Like, this is going to be tree farm in that area, and I'm going to have to figure out a way to make it so zombies don't spawn on that area, and at the same time have trees. So we'll figure something out for that. I might have to make it so that, like, when you dig up a dirt block, it becomes fertile dirt. And when you place that block down, that should actually count towards being a player-crafted block. So that way you could transport your farms up onto your roof, for example. And, well, I mean, if you're using it for farms and you hold the ground, then it becomes zombie-proof. But what if you don't hoe it? What if you're just using it for trees or you're just using it for cotton, right? So I'll make it so that when you plant the fertile dirt on the ground, it becomes a block that that zombies can't spawn on. I think that's a good solution. And you can just hear them going nuts out there. A whole shitload of zombies dying on the spikes right now. We've already done our zombie killing for the day though. We'll just take it easy. Just build. Just relax and build. This has turned kind of into a mega build, and I wasn't really planning on it, to tell you the truth. Look at how much we've gotten done so far, just today. And we spend most of the day killing zombies. What do we got here? Another 22? So yeah, we've doubled that already. Holy crap. That's awesome. Like another day and we'll have this area done, no problem. And we'll start thinking about what the hell we're gonna do with this area. Let's go take a quick peek at these guys before we end the episode. Are they still coming in, or are they done? Holy crap. This is going to be a little bit of a longer episode, I think, just because of all the zombies here. We'll just take care of them. Might as well. Something to do. I don't like how the ground gets all uneven and shit. It almost makes me want to come out here and put my own blocks down out here too. Like the cheapest blocks that we can make. Probably just wood frames. There. Now they've stopped damaging my shit. Yeah, you see, this covers up the spikes really nicely, and they end up, you know, being protected from the spikes, which allows them to take out these blocks in the middle and even up higher. You know, and with enough zombies, you know, that they could easily get over the wall even with just one lip like that. And I don't understand why the Funfips remove the gore blocks from the game. Like, they don't really cause any lag. I really don't think that these gore blocks cause any lag. Like, even with the mass amounts of them that I've got, the lag comes from other sources, I think. They just, I don't know, for some reason got it in their head that this is what caused the lag. So then they remove them. They change them to be really dumb. They change them to be just like that, and that's it. That's all that the gore block becomes. And they don't pile up, and the zombies can't really. Sure, it protects them from spikes, but that's it. They don't pile up, and they don't, you know, become like a ladder for them to get in over walls and stuff, which is, I thought, the main purpose. What I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to come around. And go like that throughout the entire frickin' just to flatten this whole area out, because I hate that when it's all bumpy. But yeah, we'll do that some other time. That's just a pain in the ass. But yeah, that's gonna do it for this episode, guys. If you enjoyed the episode, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.